There's a really powerful color grading tool inside of Lightroom and Camera Raw. We're going to look at it now. There's a really important setting in there that a lot of people never use. I'm going to explain that, and then I'm going to show you the best type of color grade to apply to different types of images. So we'll find a color grading inside the Develop module inside of Lightroom. Or if we're inside of Photoshop, we can choose Filter, Camera Raw. So yes, this tutorial works perfectly on both. So when we see the color grade, there's three different regions: shadows, midtones, highlights. Now we can view these individually if we want by clicking on here, and it's given to us nice and large. Or if we choose the global setting, it just applies a solid color across everything. But we're gonna go back here. So if we look at this fish, look at the area of black. If I go into the shadows and I start to change the color, notice how it affects mostly that shadow region. And if you look at this grayscale I added, notice that the change is mostly happening on the left, which is in this shadow region. The midtones are going to affect mainly the color of the fish. If you look in the gray bar, you'll notice that the middle part of this now changes. Notice the blacks don't get affected, the yellows don't get affected as much, mainly just the main color. I'm going to double click. And then of course the highlights, watch the tail color here. As I change that color, it mainly affects the highlight region. And you can also see on the graph here. So there's three settings on here: the hue, saturation, and the luminance. As I pull my cursor away from the middle, it goes to more saturation. As I grab this outside and I drag it around to change the hue or the color, and then the lightness is this slider under here, so we can brighten this up or we can darken it down. So the combination of these three enable us to find almost any color we want. And tips to use these: if we hold down the shift key, we can adjust just the saturation. If we hold down the control or the command key, we can adjust the hue or the color. Holding down the alt or the option key moves it slower and more precise. And if you're getting any value out of this video, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my videos. All right. So this is where I want to explain something that's kind of interesting. There's a blending and a balance. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the shadow area and let's add a little bit of color there. Okay, so if I'm there in that color, and why don't we start with the balance? If I move the balance to the left, this is going to be going towards the shadow color. Notice as I change that color, you can see a big difference. If I go into the highlights, notice you see no difference. If I move the balance over to the highlights, notice now it starts to lean towards those highlight colors, and the changes I make in the shadow will make no difference. If we go to the middle, this is where our midtones are, and now the midtone adjustment is going to be affecting it the most. So if we apply different colors, this is how we can blend them together. Notice on the slider here, let's put a little color into the shadow. Let's put a green. Notice the shadow color gets a green. We've got a red in the highlights, we can see that. And let's do something like a yellow in the midtones. Now, as I move this balance, notice what happens. I go over to starts to do the shadow color. Notice that whole bar now has got that green. So what it's doing is it's choosing that color, but it's applying it across all the tones. If we go the other way and we push it towards the highlight, which is a reddish tone, notice now that that reddish, almost fuchsia kind of a tone is now affecting the whole color bar and the fish. If we go to the middle, now we're going towards that middle color, which is a yellow. And as we adjust the mids, they will still be influenced by the shadow and the highlight. So really important setting is the blending. So notice our color bar here. It's just a gray bar. Let's add a color to the shadows. So notice we've got kind of a bluish tone there in the shadows. Let's add something to the highlights, like maybe a yellow tone. And then we're gonna do something like, I don't know, an orange in the midtones. If I pull the blending all the way to the left, you'll notice there's the blue, the orange, and the yellow. It's a little bit more separated. If I increase this blending, notice how they will blend together. See that? See how the colors will more smoothly blend? Another way to look at this, look at the colors on this rainbow here. Notice how thin the area here is of magenta, the cyan, and the yellow. Look how close they are together. As I increase this, notice that they'll spread and blend into the surrounding colors. So that's what the blending does. Keeps it very isolated in the regions, or it spreads it. Now, on most images, we're not going to be pushing full saturation on all these three tones. Let's look at something more practical. So we'll do this landscape that I shot here in a Lightroom. And so this is where this can get useful. Say I want to go into the highlights and I want to give this a nice feel, like maybe a little bit of a pinkish tone. See how we can add a little bit there? Now, if we wanted to put like a blue into the shadows, let's put a blue kind of tone into the shadows. All right, it's not quite what we want yet, is it? But notice what happens if we use the blending. See how we can blend those together? Go left, it isolates them. As we go to the right, this is where it really starts to just kind of have magic. Notice how it just smoothens out that transition. And in fact, we can play around with the balance. Do we want more of the color in the foreground? If we go to the left, it's going to give us more of the blues. If we go to right, it's going to give us more of those pinks. Let's go a little bit more to the right, get a little more pink. And I'm going to pull back on that saturation a little bit. So we don't need much of that. And notice as we're blending those together, we can get a really nice feel in that image. And see how these two sliders can really make a big difference when it comes to blending those colors. Okay, let's look at a good example for using shadows. We'll do this one in Camera Raw. Remember, these work the same in both applications. So here's one of the things I've found. For these kind of images, it works really nice to add something to the shadow. So if we go into the shadows here, we can start to just apply a cooler kind of a color into those shadow areas, just like a, you know, kind of a bluish kind of tone or even a greenish tone. For these type of images, I like to be very aware of the skin tones. Sometimes people like to boost the midtones and highlights, and that can be good to give a blockbuster filmic look. But if you want to maintain skin tones, you could focus mainly on the shadows. Now, if you did feel like you wanted to go and boost these oranges a little bit in the midtones, this is what I would do. See how it does kind of boost them, but you've got to be careful. So when I do that, I'll usually take the saturation and just pull it back just a little bit, just to keep those skin tones a little bit more natural. Okay, let's go for a cinematic color grade on this car. So we're going to choose the filter back into the Camera Raw. And I'm going to give you one more tip when we do this one. Okay, so what we're going to do is let's go for a cool kind of a vintage look where we're going to put some greenish kind of into the shadows. And then we're going to hit the highlights, a little bit of yellow. So this is kind of starting to look cool, but it's not really giving us the look we want. And that's because the missing element is to actually go down here and reduce the saturation quite a bit. And now when we do that, notice how we can bring out these colors by using the grading. We can put a little bit of yellow into the mids if we want. The other popular look is teal and orange. And that one, we would be going to the teal colors or the blues. And then we're going to hit those oranges in the highlights. And a little bit of orange in the midtones. This is what they call the blockbuster look, or the blue and orange look. It's kind of a blockbuster movie kind of a look. But what we're going to do with this is we're going to increase the shadows a little bit. Let's darken those down. And let's boost those highlights. And we might even go and reduce the saturation even more on this. Now, if we look at this before and after, that's a little bit more of a kind of a cinematic look to it. Interesting if you learned anything about the color grades. Let me know in the comments underneath if you did. So it was fun touching on the color grade. Now you can combine this with things like contrast. Check out this video here that shows you how to use contrast properly in Lightroom and Camera Raw. If you're new to the cafe, hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my tutorials. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.